Welcome to this video on the first of the Greeks, that is, delta. After completing this video, you will understand the meaning and mathematics of delta. You will also understand the concept of replication. But first, it is very important to note that knowledge of the Greeks does not give you an edge. The Greeks are risk management measurements, not sources of profits. Think of them as the instruments in a car. The speedometer tells you your speed. It does not tell you how to drive faster. Delta is defined as the partial derivative, in the calculus sense, of the option price with respect to the stock price. It is the most important Greek because stock moves are what can get us into trouble the fastest. But it is also the hedge ratio. We have seen it before. The first part of our option pricing model was to form a portfolio of a long call and short some amount, H, of stock, to hedge the directional risk. By construction, this portfolio does not change in value if the stock moves. So, if we differentiate with respect to the stock price, we see that H, the hedge ratio, is the delta. So, in order to stay hedged, we need to always know our delta. Delta is expressed either as a decimal or as a percentage. The equation for call delta is shown on the screen. As puts increase in value when the stock goes down, they have negative deltas. We can differentiate the put-call parity equation to show the relationship between the deltas of puts and calls of the same strike and expiration. There are a few special cases you should be aware of. Very far out of the money options have deltas of 0. Very far in the money calls have a delta of 1, and puts have a delta of negative 1. At the money, options have deltas close to 0.5 for calls and minus 0.5 for puts. This may not always be true. Let's explore this further. Financially, the stock can go up more than it can go down, so the directional risk is always to the upside. Hence, at the money call options have a delta of slightly more than 0.5. This can also be seen mathematically. This effect is magnified by volatility as it makes the moves bigger. When volatility is very high, very far out of the money calls can have deltas above 0.5. When this happens, the model isn't broken. It tells you something important about your risk. Delta is the tangent to the price curve. Equivalently, it is the amount that the option price changes if the stock moves by $1. Example, a 50 delta call is worth $1. If the stock increases by $1, the call increases by 50 cents. Now let's talk about replication. Replication, rebalancing, or dynamic hedging, is the process that lets us stay delta neutral and only has volatility exposure. Direction is a risk. Volatility is where we will find an edge. When we hedge, we interact with the stock, which moves according to the realized volatility. If we do this over the option's lifetime, we will have a stock portfolio whose value is the same as the option if it was priced at the underlying volatility. The replication trades will cancel out the option, no matter the final value of the stock. But often, the market price will be different to this replication price. Of course, we won't know the replication price in advance, but if we can forecast volatility, we look for situations where the options are mispriced according to our forecast. Then we trade the option, hedge and profit. This idea is very important to us, and we'll come back to it later in the course. That's all for this video.